I'll play for an hour, and then I'm taking a shower.
Alright, here's my theory on the CPUs. The way they work, so when they're behind you, they rubber band, so that he's not far. It doesn't matter how well I race, he won't be that far behind. The other theory I have is when they're in front of you, they're like unhinged. So you have to get in, you have to get in first as soon as you can, otherwise you are gonna be
hunting some Nagaraya.
Fighting and almost impossible to win battle for the rest of the race.
Alright, we're actually progressing with the dungeon now.
It's bombing. I'm lucky I didn't go flying somewhere. But I have multiple boosts because I haven't used a single boost in the entire race, so it's over. First place. Damn, I won Master, but not Expert. Alright, first in Red Canyon. I felt like I had a lot more competition that time. I was having trouble catching up for a while, but like, I got it eventually. Now it's time for White Man 1 on Master. Here we go.
I think I can map out this place completely now. I'm fairly certain these are just literal locks for the caged beasts. So I can draw them as such. There's one place I'd want to check and make sure of though.
Also note how Captain Falcon went sailing off the course. What? My god, what the heck? Come on! What?
It's very hard to make out because of the guy blocking the way.
What was that? How did I win? How the hell did I win that? I was in first the entire race, though, to be fair, and then I started having trouble at the end. He passed me, I started falling into him, stuff started going haywire, but then, miraculously, whoa, damn, how come one of the racers is, like, a weird, funny guy? What is he? He's not one of the main guys. What's he doing here? Purple man. Is Purple man here? Alright, so I've been battling for first with Yellow for a while, and basically, I feel like on Master, they're a little more feisty. He's taking these corners. Whoa, we got Long. He's taking these corners a little faster. Purple Man is in first. What the hell is this purple guy? What the heck? Whoa, I just hit that ramp. We got a double bounce. Alright, final lap. Not a boost. Not good. This purple guy, like.
Oh!
He's chill. Real. I don't know how he takes this man that fast.
These guys are so dangerous.
Oh god. First, but no boost. No insurance boost. No insurance. No insurance, but we got it. Got it, first place. First place every race in Master. Wowza, wowza. So, I think Master's a little bit harder than Expert, but it's only like a smidge. It's not like super, super crazy. And I didn't even notice it on... I didn't notice it on every map. I wasn't planning on doing that, but I guess I got sucked in.
Alright,
now we
that's
know.
Ken taken care of.
Hey, I got a new credit sequence!
What? Why is Veil faster? Oh, because Resurrect lowers your priority in the turn order, right?
Goodbye. Goodbye. From Captain Falcon.
Even Deos are faster.
Goodbye. I like the
that's the level discrepancy for you, I guess.
That's it, I guess. We're a master. We did it. Nice work, team. Okay, I'm gonna check out the King League for you guys, though. We can only do Expert on this league, but now that we know Master's not that much harder, it's not a big deal. You gotta be a freak to beat Expert mode anyways, so... Hey, why am I Captain Falcon? I'm in the wrong car. Dude. The wrong vehicle. We're on all new maps. I'm excited. Mines? Holy... Fudge.
Good to know.
Wow, that was very unexpected. Suddenly I was in hell. catch up here. First place, of course, is gone with no trace. No trace at all at first. They just, like I said, they just don't exist anymore. Wow, that was nuts. Oh, that was perfect like execution. But apparently first place was more perfect. But again, he doesn't exist. Where is first? Where is first? There he is. Dude, oh my god. Yeah, see, this I don't understand. Expert and master, there's really no... It's not a significant jump at all. In fact, I don't even know if I believe that there's really any difference. I feel like maybe a...
Authority for both cats stacks.
Like, I mean, that's
good. You can't have them together.
That's how I passed it. Good work. Good shape here. Right on my ass. Dude, what? What? It's so jarring when you run into somebody because you go freaking flying. And of course they don't hit the mines. They can't actually be impacted by the mines. What the hell? It's third place here too. Whoa. Yeah, I got one boost as long as I can maintain position. Boost at the end if necessary. Careful,
double hit is really nice.
Lines, so it's only fair that they can't hit the boost either. Yeah, to me.
I need to dismiss the beast.
Two laps in, still dominating.
Enemies, some bosses, and beasts in this floor haven't yet killed.
In the short time I've been playing,
and discovered.
So now I have gotten a lot
better.
Let's
take this opportunity to discover them.
Make some big difference for sure with overall how things are going. It's making the difference. It's making the difference between me getting left behind and me being able to like maintain my position. Also, my boosting strategy. I was wasting my boost thinking I could get hella far ahead, but it doesn't work that way. You know what I mean? They are always right behind you. Always. Make one mistake, they'll pass you. But as long as you hold on your boost, you can get your position back.
Trying to kill this guy?
Damn. Okay. First place. Let's go, man. Debunking the difficulty, F-Zero on SNES. First thing, get good. Second thing, that's it. Actually, you know what? We could turn this into a debunking episode. I do have a few tips that are actually real. Why does this look exactly the same as Fortown 1? Yeah, that's different. Yeah, that's different, but everything else was exactly the same. Ooh, cool. douche. Wait, he messed himself up too, and he slowed down, so the CPUs are affected by some stuff, like terrain and whatnot. He got boned right there, which is nice. He deserved it, freaking jerk. You know, I just really need to do another debunking the difficulty episode, and I'm like, maybe I can just make this one. But I don't think so. Although, you know what? This could be a debunking the difficulty video, because you know why? Debunking the difficulty doesn't necessarily mean the difficulty can't be debunked. It's more about the mission to find out if the difficulty can be debunked. That's just because a game is very, very difficult unless you get good doesn't mean it's not a candidate for the series. We just simply say, after much research, we have determined this game's difficulty cannot be debunked. Oh, bitch. Wow, nice recovery, though. One lap left. Oh, hey, what's up, ass? Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, that's cool, yeah. Yeah, that's really nice. Oh yeah, that's really nice. Oh yeah, that pink guy's here to give me the double stuff.
Nice.
Well, I ain't no Oreo, son. Get the hell out of here. Get out of my face, douche. I got hella boost. I get-
yeah, this
how
is awesome.
How the hell was I supposed to dodge that guy? I think I got a million boosts. Alright, we're good. Red Canyon 2. Very interested to see what the final map is.
Oh yeah, the
quest. Rainbow Road. I'm mostly curious to see if they hit me with a new concept or like a sequel to another level like Big Blue 2 or Mew City 17. Or if it's gonna be like a whole new level. God, mines. One thing for sure is I cannot wait to see these maps in 99. What the hell? They put a red guy in the middle of the night field! That was crazy! How did I not see it? What the heck? Honestly, you guys, like, I'm not even, like, trying anymore. I mean, it's like, it's not hard for me anymore. I don't know what happened. Something just, clicked inside of me, and, like, this game is so easy now. So easy. I'm just in first all the time. And if, you know, something happens, I just boost and get my spot back. It's easy. Easy peasy. Major lemon squeezy. Oh my god, I'm bouncing all over the place. Wow, first place. Okay, one race left, you guys. What is the final map in Night League gonna be? What's it gonna be? Fire Field. That sounds really familiar. Wow, that name sounds really familiar. Cool, it's a new map. That is what I was hoping for. I like how these guys dodge the
lines. Why can't I use my limits? Did they not set them?
Freaking buttholes. I know you guys won't take damage if you touch one. Come on. You can't fool me. Wow. Okay, this is like the map to end all maps, I guess. Okay, every time I'm gonna take a turn, I'm gonna get bonked and like skid out. Is that what's gonna happen here? Cause that's gonna get real annoying. What is that? They're on it. Do I wanna be on that? What was that? Was that healing? Or magnets?
Ooh.
Two ways to go. Wait, the other way I have a boost. That must have been healing. Wow, this course doesn't
this guy's very powerful. I need a lot of defense.
Okay then. I might not be able to catch up because I had quite a rough start, but I'll see what I'll try. I'll see what I can do.
Yeah, fuck.
Damn, these turns are like impossible. I must not be doing them right. Ow. The only map where I've had like power. Not good. No, that doesn't heal you either. Wait, there's no healing on this map at all.
Whoa. I'm running away.
Oh, smoked. Like, placement-wise.
A dirt
ball. Not too good, I'll say that much. Okay, I mean, hold on, I gotta figure out these turns. They're really tight. They're not working how I was typically turning in every other level. Okay, yeah, thanks, buddy. A little better, still some damage, though. Alright, so I'm gonna go over here, get a little bit of healing. I like that boost, though. Actually, that was not worth it, because I went to get that boost, and just the guy that was in front of me just completely vanished. Typical F-Zero CPU move right there. Alright, I'm gonna give up and restart. Alright, let's try again. This one is not messing around, this is a serious track. Based on what I can tell, if you lose the CPUs in this one, you are... it's over. Like, if they're gone, like, outside, slow down, turn, and take it in the face. Because there was a dick right on the turn. Oh yeah, that's cool, that's nice, yeah. Thanks, bud. Yeah, thanks for that.
This is the team.
That's great. Oh yeah, that's great. Yeah, that's great. Yeah, that's real great. I flew up on the hell. Saddest thing I've ever seen in my life. Wow, 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 wow. Third place is here too. It's a party, I guess. I have no boost, so I'm in a bad position here. All it takes is like one stupid thing to happen, and I won't be able to win. Because I need my boost. I need my boost for the ending. I think I got this. There it is. Very nice. Yeah, he was pretty close, wasn't he? Alright, there you have it, folks. I think that was first place on every map in the 90 on expert difficulty. Firefield was challenging, for sure. You really couldn't make any mistakes. I mean, not much. Not much. Damn, 3.5 minutes for Firefield. That's a long one. Oh, check it out, you guys. Oh, it let me skip it this time. Wow. Oh, nice. Very nice of it. I haven't unlocked any new leagues. I don't know if there's any other leagues in this game. Let me just look it up while I have you guys here.
The only one that I consider that it up worth.
So these are all the maps that are available. The only additional challenge I can give myself would be
what would her ability to insta-kill?
You guys want to see Firefield Master difficulty, don't you? They're putting up more of a fight in Master. Not much I'll say for sure. Like, these guys keep popping up. They keep popping up. They're popping up a little more aggressively than they did on Expert. You know, I had to, like,
point proven
down to maintain my spot. First place. Bada bing, bada boom. A boom! Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I have returned to the fire field for your pleasure. I know y'all wanted to see it. I feel like it really completes this video to do fire field on Master and beat it, so let's see how it goes. Every track up to this one has been a complete snore. I had no difficulty at all beating any map on Master. Just first place every time. Really quite amazing stuff. So we'll see how this one goes. You know, maybe we'll leave the entire unedited track just for fun, we'll see how it goes.
Of course, maybe we'll leave that
for me. First, which is nice. Good place to be. What's that terrain all about? Weird. Alright, first lap. Good. Do we have anything to worry about? I don't know. I really don't. not sure. I think I got this track pretty much down though, you know? I mean, obviously I'm sure I could do it better, but... well enough to beat the computers anyways. Seems long.
I'd find this really useful.
And the flat is still holding on to my position. I'm gonna hang left if we got a bogey in the middle of the map. Don't care for that much. Yeah, boosted right there, but there really was no reason to. Doesn't get me any further ahead of my opponents. Gets me a better lap time, I guess. Still holding, 2 laps left. Whoa, he was camped in the middle. Wow. That's crazy. Oh, here he is. Green guy passed me. Now it's gonna get freaky, man. Got a little bit of competition.
There you go.
Guys in the room.
Combine's good enough.
Also. They're like the biggest issue, really, because they take up a whole damn road. Second now. And I'm about to explode. I gotta take the long way, I gotta heal. What? Where's green guy? Where? How? There's no way he got that far ahead from me getting healed.
So
no way.
Icicle.
I just did through it too.
I see, it has ice attacks. Being able to counter that might be a good idea.
How many boosts? I don't know. Wait, we're on the final lap, right? Focus then. Bring it home. We're fine then. On final, we're fine. Yeah, good. Cool. Don't you even dare, dude. Look at that. Well, other than green guy coming up out of nowhere and almost raining on my brand, that wasn't too bad. Every single race, I was first. Every lap, first. About Firefield, third. Went down to third after that lap. That's crazy. Cool, that's it. Well, like, subscribe. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. I felt like the beginning was incredibly hectic. And then after... something clicked where I just ascended just enough to where all of a sudden the game looked trivial. Like at some point, the difficulty for me just vanished. It was completely gone. So how hard is the original F-Zero? I would say the game, if you're playing on the harder difficulties, I would say it's hard. It's very hard unless you're at a certain level, and then if you're at that level, it becomes pretty easy. I guess that's it, there's really nothing left. I think we beat the hardest that this game has to offer. So, thank y'all for watching. I'll see you all in F-Zero 99. Can't wait for Firefield to be introduced to that game.
Oh, Zone Blaze this time. I see, it uses all sorts of elements. Fuck. I have a hunch. No, it changed. Never mind. I thought it was like whatever element I last used against her, that's what she uses. Oh fuck. Oh, fuck. I think a bit more damage output rather than defense might be useful. I feel like I can replace Lubobi here. I'm sticking to Mara. Looks like I'm back to this team in the end.
that that's going, we should be able to get this second one down here. It's really actually not that complicated, but I made an absolute meal out of it. But who are you to judge, huh? You're not playing the game. I am. I'm in control. I could literally just stop this episode right now if I wanted to. But I won't. These do a thing now. Crystal things in the sand. Did they disappear when you get them? Nope. So now it's gonna be confusing which ones I have and which ones I don't. I guess not, if they have a glowing shard in the middle of them. Wow, look at all those babies. This one, since I'm finding it later, could be much harder.
Now that I've spent that mask, bro, I'm strange to imagine an acting boat. You should raise the boat, right?
Jesus.
Counterproductive, but a little bit can help.
Get it, Atreus! Not too far away! No, not.
The first time it's 10% increase, but afterwards it's only 5%.
Yeah, I'd be able to break them if I could actually hit them.
But like level 10, it's like 170 or something. Per V3. Which I don't think is worth it.
Oh, there's more.
Too much investment.
I can spend
that
on actually get two?
Getting proper
skills and stuff. If you broke one, it just defaulted back to
enhancing
fighting.
Enhancing attacks. No, why?
Listen. That looks like it hurt, Atreus! Oh god. Hey, wait. Ouch. At least he's not doing that much damage. I keep missing his glowies! Nailed it! Nailed it! Are you kidding me? Nice! Where is he? Give me your ball! So much weaker, even I can kill it! Time to turn you into wine. Loot. Nice. Okay, I need to burn that. Can't reach it. Wrong arrows, I did the wrong arrows. I wonder if I can actually stop.
You can just get
it. Actually,
never mind, it's poison.
Off this up into that and down. From here, brother! Is this journey? It's called trip. Alone yet together, close yet apart, our long scarves a tether, cooperation and art. Speak without words. Quest through the land, glide like a bird, draw names in the sand. Yeah, that's journey. Oh, I missed one. Celestial Constructs is Astro Boy. This is Spirits Within Walls. No, I saw that somebody said this was Horizon. Imagine, dear reader, if you so dare, creatures of metal that screech through the air. That seems obvious now. But this symbol was confusing. Art Society Ground Orb the Performance. I don't know what this one is. It seems like it should be really obvious though. But again, the episodes haven't come out fully yet, and I haven't had a chance to like read all the comments, so you guys will have given the answer by the time this episode's out, and I just don't know it yet. But I appreciate you anyway. Thanks for helping. Is that all to get through this section? Oh, that's so cool looking now. Blast him right in his titties. Nice. Hop on, Atrey! I flew the long way around, huh? Can't make life easy for me.
Thank you.
He's right. Things can always be worse. I remind myself that often.
You know what
about Mars? There will be no fun to be had. Money! Myself temporal significance? Using on the scent of a book. When the paper is fresh, it carries the gentle notes of the plants it came from, light, floral, with a touch of sweetness. As time passes, the pages age, they take on their brittle tan, a tear forms. From any source, any force stronger than the softest of touches, the scent hardens, crisp at the beginning, moving into the earthly moss left behind from the dust, desert air, and insect feasts. These ephemera, nearly as impermanent as ourselves, do we entrust the collective knowledge of our elven histories. Is this venture foolish? I conceive the fleeting nature of existence, be it of flesh or scroll, yet I would not trade the pleasure of putting ink to page from all the treasures in common. And then we're going to talk about time travel. What? All visitors must observe strict silence inside the library, even in the vestibule passageway. No books to leave the premises. Transcriptions of any material within the library are supposed to be damaged to the library materials. Let's just add some flavor to the area, but it doesn't add lore.
Whoa! That was not easy. Not quite done yet. I'll go finish this quest and then I'll go take a shower. It's so hot. And minimize the threat to just be a single one.
Where is it? Well, that should stand out, shouldn't it? There are those who built this tower who gave everything they had to complete it, but where did I put them in the ground? I was almost one of them. Never again, I leave this treasure in the hopes that whoever needs it may find it, and in so doing, is reminded of their own worth. No tower, no matter how great, is worth one's life. Absolutely. What's that?
Instant kill makes a lot of things super convenient. And not having that really sucks.
We are the caretakers of truth, the arbiters of knowledge, protectors of this repository of enlightenment that stretches back to our earliest writings, ancient as the sands. It is our sacred duty to protect our
elven
learnings and prevent the possible spread of it to those who cannot reconcile the wisdom found within these walls. The benighted masses cannot be trusted, cannot be expected to assimilate these truths. They lack the intellectual fortitude to absorb and accept the divisive nature of certain revelations. This suppression is not cruelty, nor is it an attempt to control. It is mercy, pure and simple. Okay. Very good, lads. More pots that I hath not breaketh. More and more. So much money. Get out of my way, boy!
Like, really, like,
it's very.
coming. More XP for me.
Use your shield strike, brother! Nice, 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 nice. This is gonna be a hard fight. I can already tell by how little damage I'm doing. Not the weapon I thought I had out. Whee! Dang it! Ah! Damage! Just in time. I can't dodge or anything, Christ!
There you go.
I'm blocking, I'm dodging, nothing's working. I know, but I'm too far away. Almost there! Nice!
You're joking.
Maybe. Believe it or not.
Alright.
Let's try it.
Time to look up a walker. I give up. I don't know how to solve this. I've solved these types of puzzles before where you use a switch and then it changes the state of itself as well as all other nearby things to it. Well, it isn't exactly like that, but it's similar to it, and I have solved puzzles like this before, but this one's got me lost, and I just don't wanna. I just don't wanna bother. That's how they mapped it. they're not part of the Monsters Codex. Push all of the buttons once except for X. Go to area 485A. Check the four walls of the pillar at the center. Push all of the buttons once except for... It's that simple. Oh my god. One 70 is not good at all. Fail on the back. Yeah, cloning herself anyway, do. Double the chances of getting the instant kill, which really isn't all that useful. Her summons can be at the front end, it'll still be safe. I'm pretty sure. I can also just not bring Veil. I hate that they remove Switch Strike. It's such a useful tactic. If I ever wanted to summon ES double, Umag can just use that attack. I mean, it is technically just really useless for the most part, but for what it's worth, it had its uses. Ah, right. I wanted... What happens if... I just bring Veil on her own? Get off the XP. Alright, Paralysis Hammer. That's nice. Ah, it was just 5,200. Dang it. That's not nearly enough. So annoying. The Volby doesn't have the thingy that heals like Mara does. But this will still be a good team, I think. Way more useful. Oh. Beheading works on anyone, on any weapon. Bruh, that's a bruh moment. I don't mind if I do that, but I'm gonna try getting that. For Alma, if you don't mind. Ah, right, I wanted Mystic Calm level 5. Hell yeah. Now pretty much everything barely costs anything except for the stuff that just costs a lot. just by default. Deals more damage in the back row. Each Bradov is at level 5. How annoying. Focus on more defense or more offense. Both. It's our exploration team for the next episode. Taking a shower now.